Hello, Papa Love YouTube. It is me again. So, I was browsing PD2 forum and came across a lot of interesting topics. So, this user wanted to know how to check the weapon's damage because he or she was having a hard time adjusting to the new promising shotgun build, which doesn't seem to deliver the numbers. How odd! So, aside from that, I would also like to add on a question of mine. Is it really that important to know your weapon damage? For me, there is no such thing as a stupid question, no matter how ridiculous it might sound. Everything's okay for me. New players might not realize this, but the general idea on the workings in Payday 2 is that high damage weapons have low ammo pickup rate. Okay, low damage weapons have higher ammo pickup rate. So, part of Payday 2's gameplay requires a player to think about ammo management. If you are going into a long hike, for example, like maybe cooking 24 bags of meth, or an hour game plus, or like death sentence in one down, you have to pick a reasonable weapon. By reasonable, I mean not picking dual Desert Eagle Akimbo for primary and Desert Eagle pistol for secondary. You will run out of ammo in a matter of minutes. That is just a bad idea. And a very simple example. Okay. So, to answer the first question, how do I check the weapon damage? Okay. The answer is actually very simple. It's in your safe house, provided you have upgraded the John Wick shooting range and Sokol's hockey gym. Okay. John Wick's shooting range is for weapons with bullets or grenades. Anything that flies out from a thingy, alright? Sokol's hockey gym, on the other hand, has a punching bag, which you can use your melee weapons and see the damage output. The difference between a normal hit and a charged hit, there's a difference, alright? So, of course, these numbers here are just pure, raw numbers. Not the actual damage figures that you will see when hitting on enemies with different damage absorption rate. Alright, so which brings me to question number 2. Do you really need to know your weapon damage? Is it must an important thing? Okay. My honest answer is generally no. Okay. You can have a look at the next few minutes of video, okay, and you tell me how much damage am I doing exactly to a particular unit or particular enemy. I have a hood mod and I'm also doing the video editing. I myself have no idea how much damage I'm actually doing. Alright? Unless I go and record every game that I play and check every shot I make frame by frame, then I will know exactly how much damage I'm doing, which is a bit tedious and ridiculous. Okay? So, how do I gauge or how do I measure whether a weapon is up to par for a certain difficulty, right, I measure it by magazine clips or by the number of shots that I make. If I use 2 to 3 shots to take out a taser or a magic unit, I guess that's acceptable for me. Okay. In the next video, you will see I'm actually using the smart shotgun, and I think I unloaded like 3, 4, 5 magazines into the face of the LMG dozers, but it's still working. To me, that's acceptable. That's okay. But for someone else, for you, are you comfortable with that amount? See, if you are not, it means you will need to go through the process that I just showed you. Go to the shooting range, see how much damage you're doing. Pick another weapon and see how much damage you're doing. And then go to a game for the actual field test. Okay. Yeah. So that's basically my recommendation and my answer to this particular question. So happy gaming! Ta-ta!